Okay, it's been recorded. Okay, Diana is asking, kenapa, macam mana Diana sekali lagi?
Saya tanya, kan the word for to apply tu, bukan saya cakap tadi tak payah letak to apply kan, specifically cakap, so just do in another separate paragraph, is it?
Betul. I take back. Jangan buat separate paragraph. It is supposed to be macam ni tau. Kalau you tengok satu benda, masalah, masalah tu di depan you. Say for example, you have a problem X. Now X is in front of you. Now you want to give some opinion about the problem, about X by virtue of juris. So belakang X ni, imagine the lembaga X is in front of you. Belakang the object of the shadow of X which is in front of you, belakang tu ada several juris. You know, if can you imagine that? So kalau you boleh imagine that, meaning the problem is the one yang you nak kena tackle. It's not the juris. Ini dia orang are more concerned about the juris themselves. Juris tu ada depan dia. Sekejap dia tengok juris A and then they try to apply to the problem. Problem X ni duduk dekat belakang juris tu. Can you get what I'm trying to say or not? I sepatutnya I nak buat something. Wait, eh? Yeah, eh? Maksudnya?
Just to clarify, does that mean that we have to put our focus on the problem itself rather than emphasizing on the juris itself, because juris is just the supporting things that we learn to solve the problem at hand? And also when you said that we shouldn't use the word apply, does it mean that we have to integrate together so that it doesn't look like we are segregating our answer, meaning that we're fusing the law and the application at the same time?
Yes, yes, you are right there. Because kalau lah kita letak that so-called problem behind, then it will be in the nature that susah nak tulis pun tak boleh. Tapi tak apalah, what we are going to do, look at the problem, we are looking at the problem rather than the juris. So kalau you letak the juris in front, you know, you are talking about heart. If you want to talk about heart, the chances of you trying to elaborate heart further in order for you to make sure that you are comfortable with heart, and then you start to apply. So X punya problem is behind heart, which is not supposed to. Because the question is about the problem. So the problem is the question, meaning X must be in front for you to be able to start with the problem. So you don't apply. So the moment you ambil the juris in front, then the chances of you to relate to the problem, itu yang akan jadi ada separate. One is about the juris, the second is about the application of the juris idea to the problem. So what you are supposed to do is to look at the problem all the way from the moment you start answering to the moment you finish your answer. Kalau dalam semua problem, all the problems tu, you will be looking at all the juris. Nanti kalau kita tengok, nanti kita tengok sini lah. Ada sampel-sampel yang lain. So can you understand? One problem is this argument, one paragraph trying to explain one juris and then try to apply, which is what do you mean by it? This is a clear reason why Ahmad's sister fully support. This is a clear reason. You kena elaborate what is the clear reason. Okay, so walaupun dia kata it is a banned interstate travel, so you have to give interrelationship with the human law of ataupun the theory of Thomas Aquinas. Mana dia punya reasoning dia? Betul tak? If you're talking about Thomas Aquinas, they are the rational thinking, right? To look at the law and then rationalize it, and then whether the law, mana dia punya divine law, what they call it, divine and then natural law, the eternal law, where is the those? Tak ada. Yeah? So it is not about discussing about those laws ataupun those theories yang Aquinas cakap. It's about the application itself. So kalau you tengok problem tu, you akan nampak problem from Thomas. Bukannya Thomas and then apply, trying to apply Thomas kat problem tu. There's two different scenario altogether. Beza tau. Beza. So you kena tengok problem. Problem is the one that is most important. Soalan. Ini Allah. Saya pula tak share. Ada soalan?
Yes, sir. Hi. Good evening, sir. Assalamualaikum.
Adi, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, thank you so much, sir. I just have a question, sir. If it's multi-approach and multi-approach, apa nama application? I would say application. Multi-approach thesis, right? So, like for example, problem, and then should we elaborate all of the thesis in a should we explain all of the thesis or just explain a big chunk of it? I mean, like, macam, how do we? I wouldn't want to say apply because you say it's not applying the situation. I would say, how would we how do we compare it? How do we need to do a comparison between the thesis, the theories?
If you are talking about two, three people, or you're talking only one?
I say, let's say there's two jurists, but they are on the same subject. They are on the same theories, right? So should we have a comparison of both of these juries, or should we just I would say apply it then? I mean, I'm sorry, not apply.
You are to discuss the relationship of the problem from the perspective of that particular jurist. So you cannot do that. It's rather than you don't have to go and compare with other people. If you can do that, then you will see macam ni 19-20 punya answer. You know, they are able to go to that extent. So I akan bagi di sini 12. Sorry, I tak share. I bagi 12. And then I bagi 15. Then I bagi 17. And then I bagi 19. You akan tengok dia punya beza. So I'm going to give you the answer of all these groups in order for you to compare and contrast. So to answer you, meaning you don't have to go to that extent. It is not expected, but if you were to get 18, 19, 20, you know, you can go to that extent to compare and contrast. The maturity of your answer is going to be the one that kita akan appreciate by giving you more marks. Kalau lah kata mundane macam ni, tak ada dia nak bagi yang Thomas Aquinas sendiri pun dah tak ada. Nak apply pun tak dalam satu ayat je. You know, can you expect marks given for that? No, ridiculous lah kan? Betul tak? It does not make sense for me or any examiner to be able to do that. So that is with respect of a jurist. So mode attack ialah attack the problem rather than picking the juries and then trying to explain the juries, applying the juries to the problem. That is going to be very odd. You know, some students they all dapat buat sikit saja. Some student they elaborate more about the juries and the application memang sikit gila. You know, thinking that they are able to do it. So yang tu problem lah. Soalan? Can someone answer those group yang siapa yang tak boleh masuk tu? I'm recording, so I can share with you later. So you tengok eh, ni yang pertama. So kita tengok yang second pula. Now, this is the question. Think Juris 1. This is a question about historical school and theory of sovereignty. Boleh nampak soalan? For those, the Juris 2.
Jelas, sir. Jelas.
Okay. So tengok answer dia. Obviously, they tried the attempt of bolding the ataupun you memang you kena exam, you kena highlight, you kena highlight, use for example colors and things like that. Satu, dua, tiga, empat. For a 20 mark. And then they expect to get more marks than that is needed. So, berapa orang? Kita tengok dalam juri. Satu. Tiba-tiba buat keluar Bodin pula ni. Mana datang Bodin ni? Okay, things that is not in the syllabus. Kenapa you tak boleh letak anything one that is not discussed dalam syllabus? Because we have to have a standard to be able to compare your paper and your and the other students' paper. Barulah kita boleh nampak, okay, student yang number satu ni dia bagi 10 juris. Student number dua bagi 5 juris from the syllabus. So kalau syllabus ada 20, the question is related to 10 juris, then the expectation of 10 juris in the answer. Tapi kalau student tu hanya bagi 3 juris, then I will boleh compare kalau student tu bagi 8 juris. You know, 8 as compared to 2. So it has to be some a standard, has to be maintained. But you don't bring in somebody else that is not related. Now ni Austin. Hopes. Tiga je. You know, at least yang ni lagi banyak. Okay, kalau you nak kira kan, compare this one. I think I share my whole snippet. Nanti senang sikit. Macam mana? Okay, kalau compare ni, dia ada berapa? Satu, dua, tiga, empat. Luther King ni dengan lah. Empat. Empat. Yang ni ada berapa? Satu. Civic ni. Austin. Oops. Tiga. I don't see anyone else. Okay, so ini in terms of the juris. In terms of the answer, the depth of the answer or the discussion that was raised. So, dia kata here he brought in Sivigny, they brought in Sivigny. And then they try to elaborate. Okay, law is a phenomenon of society where a sovereign. So, any it is trying to elaborate lah. As I mentioned, kalau you approach you dengan menggunakan problem as your main idea, you terus jump. Okay, you terus look at the problem straight. Maksudnya, here, where is the problem? The application dia mana? Can anyone see? Mana ada problem? Because soalan dia kata Here, with regards to parliament and constitution, okay, fine, right. Okay, now dia try talk about the federal constitution. Dan relate, boleh dia tak dia relate kepada command theory? Sebab you are talking about Savigny kan? What is Savigny punya idea? Anyone?
Vogtsdijs, sir.
Vogtsdijs. Mana perkataan Vogtsdijs tu? Cari dalam sini. Start from here until here. Ada Vogtsdijs. Cuba baca. Nampak tak? Ada tak?
Tak ada, sir.
Tak ada kan? So, macam mana? How do you expect me to give you marks when the core of that idea from Savigny tak ada? Where is the spirit of the society in terms of that? Yeah? So macam mana? There is no application that is related to the problem. Mana command? Mana command? Positive law, positive theory of sovereignty. What do you mean by theory of sovereignty? Tak ada pun. Command theory. So, theory of sovereignty macam. And then they try to relate. Oh, what do you mean by relate? Theory of sovereignty means what? Allahu Akbar. Sovereign kan? Mana sovereignnya? Where is the discussion about sovereign? Tak ada. This is just elaboration. The identity or sovereignty. This is just macam seolah-olah Consti punya answer, which is wrong. Dia tak ada relationship with the juris yang kita nak discuss ni. So nampak tak, dia orang letak juris and then they try to relate to the problem. However, dia punya relationship tak ada kena mengena langsung dengan theory of sovereignty ataupun command theory that is being proposed by Austin. Mana ada punishment ni? Command theory comprises of what? Dia mesti ada sovereign, mesti ada command, dia kena ada punishment. So you kena relate to the problem lah. Mana the relationship to this problem? Eh, so boleh nampak guys? Ada soalan nak tanya? Yes. Faham eh? Alhamdulillah.
Faham, sir.
Okay. So ini yang 12 markah. So kita dah tengok tadi, this one. Ni mention this like lex injusta non est lex ni, yes you can put it in but it does not carry any marks because you don't apply to the problem, right. Sama dengan inilah, kalau dia try to explain theory of sovereignty, dia tak boleh nak relate. What do you mean by that? Dia ni salah ni, apa yang dia buat ni actually is wrong. This is not it. I can easily cross it over and kata ni this is outside the application, which is wrong application. Right. Now moving on to yang ni yang dapat 15 markah. This is with regards to juris 2 eh. Juris 2 sama aja juris 1 juris 2. It's just about the juris saja yang berbeza. So here the question is asking you to look at Tamanaha, right? So they try to elaborate. Try not to elaborate the person, because this you can easily find dalam you know materials outside. Especially you dalam keadaan COVID, you boleh cut and paste from other information, which is this does not carry any mark. So what? Yeah. So if we were to put it in dalam exam, it does not give you any point. Don't expect me to give you point, because you can easily find it dalam exam, dalam internet. Tapi dalam exam hall, I think I can give some marks lah. Tapi sikit sangat. Kalau 1/20 mungkin setengah. Okay, so he emphasized in terms of influence and things like that. Okay, fine. Because this at the assignment, right? Nampak tak dia kata to apply, excuse me. To apply to require restriction. Nampak tak the separation between the body, you know, which is actually tak, actually dia cerita banyak tentang benda lain yang bukan dengan Taman Naha punya idea. What you have to discuss is about the idea of Taman Naha with regards to his theory, that is relationship, with having relationship to the problem. Itu second approach yang kalau you nak ambil lah. Tapi the better approach is to take the problem and discuss it from Taman Naha punya perspective. So the problem is the one, the core. It's not the one that is you introduce Taman Naha baru you nak relate to the problem. Nampak tak dia punya beza, eh? Nampak dengan sampel yang ni dengan yang ni, dia punya ayat tu dah lain. Besides, for example, you know, then dia dah start dah, this means what. Okay, but the problem here di sini ialah dia try to put in terms of comparative, yeah, to jadi momentum. You kena discuss dulu problem tu rather than compare and contrast with other juries. So you master that one first. So in this case, dia telah sambung, dia explain pula John Austin. This type of differences causes endless scuffle amongst the juries, which Taman Naha described as detrimental. And so you kena explain lagi lah. For that reason, dia boleh identify lah. And then, now, nampak tak? Dia kata to apply. You discuss, discussion between the several juries. You ada sini, Bantam, Austin dengan Taman Naha, right? But the application only take part here, sini. Sini yang penting ni. Dalam exam, we are looking at how you are able to compare and contrast juries melalui the problem. So in this case, they try to apply Taman Naha to the problem. Okay, they start lah. The first criteria, the second criteria. So dia akan letak ni, for example, dia nak compare and contrast. Boleh, tak ada masalah. But it is not to the core of the question. If you are the core of the question, ingat soalan ni, kalau those jurist tu, you boleh nampak, dia minta set up by Taman Naha. Kenapa you nak masuk benda-benda orang lain? You know, you want to evaluate something, you look at the question. Again and again, I kata tengok soalan. Kalau soalan tu kata Taman Naha, the rest is immaterial. You don't have to bring those people in into nak bagi bunga-bunga, tak payah. Because the concentration is Taman Naha to the problem that is given. I think problem that is given in this question is slightly with regards to COVID, kan? Those are yang jurist tu, siapa yang boleh ingat soalan? Okay, so dia nak apply the COVID-19 punya situation. So di sini they try to do that, which is okay, moderate, boleh, by doing the general, and then they start on to the to the nitty-gritty of the point. Yeah, so they nak compare and contrast. You don't need to compare and contrast because you have to go deep into the apa orang kata, into the discussion of Taman Nahar. Dia bagi steward meal, dia bagi Savigny, you know. Then they try to bagi example, you know. That example has to be elaborated. Kalau ada soalan tanya, kenapa, apa pentingnya example dalam exam? You kena tanya diri you, kenapa you nak kena letak example? Kalau exam example tu is just nak bunga-bunga without you able to relate, then it is meaningless. Nampak tak? Dia kata as abortion is historical, a taboo, section 312. What is the relationship of this example to the problem that is given? Mana dia punya nexus, dia punya link, you know? What you are trying to say here is, you jangan lari daripada topic. You jangan lari daripada problem. Problem is clear that is given to you. Jangan lari daripada problem tu. You nak bagi example lain, boleh. Tapi you kena relate balik kepada problem. You cannot just give like this. You know, macam tergantung. For what purpose that you are giving this? What is that relationship with Taman Nahar? Sebab yang ni dia bagi kata Civic ni. You know, soalan dah, jawapan dah cacah merbah. Dalam application of Secretariat of Taman Nahar, ada Civic ni, ada Mills, applying Mills principle. Because the question is very straightforward about Taman Nahar. Kenapa you nak bunga-bungakan, nak campur dengan benda lain yang tak sepatutnya? Then baru dia nak try to maintain peace and things like that. Baru dia nak try to apply, which is a problematic. Okay, nak bagi Hugo Grotius punya issue applying again, nampak konsep applying to the above criterion. So A is on Taman Nahar, which dia pusing mengata Sebik ni ada, Pound ada, pening kepala. Okay, so yang the most important thing, the question is about Taman Nahar. Concentrate on Taman Nahar sahaja. Then B is about Roscoe Pound. Kalau Roscoe Pound, then Roscoe Pound throughout. You can compare and contrast and saying that Roscoe Pound ni dia lain sikit lah. Kalau kita ambil Roscoe Pound, kita apply, you will see different application. So kalau in that situation, that is secondary. You nak masuk orang lain, jangan masuk because tak, soalan tak tanya pun. You know, what you have to, because according to Roscoe Pound theory, legal theory. So you explain Roscoe Pound and then you do your balancing, conflict of interest, betul tak? Yeah, it is about the conflict of interest, the where is the social engineering punya explanation, you know, what do you mean by social engineering? Conflict of interest bahagi dengan berapa? How many conflict of interest between individual, social and public? Okay, dia bagi ni legal interest. Okay, what do you mean by legal interest? Where is the application? Kita kena tanya juga. So nampak, for example yang ni, okay, does it relate to the problem that is given? Then dia bagi public interest. What do you mean by public interest? Then the application of the public interest. Kata question ada mention about fake news apa semua kan? So you nak bagi example in saying that this is the, these examples must be related to the public interest. What do you mean by that? So kalau you tengok example ni, in cases reported live broadcast made by daily by Datuk Noor Hisham, security necessary, what is the public punya impact? Ni, dia nak bagi example. Tapi apa relationship with the interest of the public? And this is just a fact. Okay, dia bagi statement to the society, what is the COVID punya situation? Apa relationship of this example, apa significant of this example. Kalau you nak masuk example, you kena relate to the problem. You kena relate to the idea that is you want to highlight. Kalau di sini you nak kena highlight, untuk nak buat law, kita kena tengok public interest, balancing of that, right? Balancing of public interest. So macam mana kita nak buat balancing? You bagi example. So dalam example ni tak ada, mana balancing ni? You tell me, ada tak balancing? Tak ada public punya interest ataupun the balancing of public interest kat sini. Yes, I'm not saying that the example is wrong. Tetapi the example tak boleh nak direlatekan kepada problem yang dia yang you nak try to discuss, which is rules compound public punya balancing, public interest punya balancing. Where is the public interest balancing di sini? Tak ada. So this is just information. This is not the answer that I am expecting, right? So dia nak bagi society, society punya interest pula, right? Then dia bagi example. Tak ada lah, dia tak bagi example. So dia, ini dia nak try to apply, right? Macam mana dia nak apply this social interest? Then you talk about the government and the society. Macam mana pula? Dia punya application tu tak berapa. Ni dia bagi example. So dia nak the efficient as possible. To build an efficient structure of the society. Itu aim of that particular law. However, what is the balancing yang you nak dapat daripada the social? That balancing has to be there. You nak try to talk about berita harian and say, you must relate back. You know, the government make decision to strengthen the penalties balance of social interest. How do you justify that? Dia kena balik ke problem. Kalau you tak bincang about the problem, the chances you akan orang kata you akan merapu, you akan mengarut. You akan ambil example that is related, you nampak macam related tapi tak boleh apply to the principle ataupun to the doctrine that is ataupun to the model yang Pound try cakap. Pound kata kita kena balance the in order for you to create good laws, it has to be balanced between public, private and public. Society, the social, the individual and the public. So tiga orang atau tiga organ ataupun tiga area that you have to look into. So by giving example, you have to relate to the to the thing that you want to discuss. Walaupun you datang dengan My Sejahtera, which is relevant to the question, you know, to the relationship of the question, but you have to go back to the, you have to, orang kata, matikan argument you. You kena matikan argument tu back to the one that you started off. Habis. Ini yang 15. Let's look at the soalan untuk yang 15 ni. Ada soalan? Kita tengok yang
so yang maksud saya kena compare and contrast yang three types of interest tu, maksudnya kena mix dalam satu paragraf lah antara dua interest tu yang kita compare contrast.
Oh, tak payah. You don't need, you nak tengok the rationality of that tiga-tiga interest, betul tak? So in this case assignment, so you can put it in three separate paragraph. Dalam paragraph, each paragraph you akan ada contoh-contoh dan you akan relate contoh-contoh tu balik kepada the interest yang you nak cakap. Say for example, you nak kata private interest or individual interest. If you are talking about individual interest, then you talk about example apa yang you boleh kata rights of a person to move back to their kampung in order for them to look to the welfare or welfare of their parents, right? So that is the interest of an individual. You ask any individual in Malaysia right now, the interest of them to be able to go back to see their loved one is the priority. So you take that example and then you balik kata, you emphasize, kata nak balik kampung is the one that is so important for them to satisfy. And the law have to accommodate that ability for them to go back to their hometown. That because this is by nature is the individual interest. You cannot deny that. It is interest of individual. However, you letak another paragraph. Okay, now let's discuss the interest of the public, meaning the government. What is the interest of the government? The interest of the government is to be able to control COVID from spreading, right? In order to do that, the government have to ensure that the MCO is the one that is being adhered to. However, you boleh kata the problem of the government is whereby some quarters of the government or members of the parliament are abusing that so-called interest. You know, the interest of the general administration of the government is to control COVID from spreading, but within the government itself, there are people who doesn't care about the restriction. You know, and di situ you nak emphasize the importance of the public punya approach or public punya interest. So you have to take example and relate back that example to the problem of the the problem of what you want to say. In this case, the public interest. Kan? Public interest is the government interest, the administrators of the country. Dia banyak benda yang dia nak kena jaga in terms of the well-being of their the doctors, well-being of their the security people, police and things like that. Because those people are their staff. So it is in the eyes of the government to make sure that those interests, their interests as the government to be adhered to. Meaning the law must reflect their interest as compared to individual interests. And then you boleh buat another paragraph, you talk about the society interest. You know, the society interest macam mana, apa yang dalam COVID punya movement yang relate to the society punya interest. What is the interest of the society? Well-being of the society to be able to earn money. You know, to be able not to have that fear that you won't be having your own work anymore. You know, and to stay at home in a society whereby the increase of mental pressure, abuse between family members because you are staying every day in and out seeing each other. So from the society punya point of view, dia punya interest is different. So you can give example of whatever choice that you want to take or to give and then relate back, nak emphasize, nak matikan you punya argument and saying that look, my example is correct because this is a society interest that needs to be identified. Then you boleh letak the fourth paragraph. You boleh kata, look at paragraph one, individual interest. Second is the public interest, and then the society interest. They are conflicted. So what you need to do the balancing. Which one is more important as compared to the other? Okay, the subject matter is COVID. Subject matter, the problem that is in front of you right now is COVID. Macam mana Ina? Identify from one person pound, and dalam pound punya model dia kata ada tiga interest that you have to balance. And then yeah, you boleh buat balancing, then up to you lah. Do you say which one is more important? Because there is no correct answer. You can easily say public interest is more important because it relates to the society problem, and then eventually if society is happy, jangan masuk bantam pula kat dalam ni. If the society happy, then obviously the public is be able to adhere to their interest. You know, the police tak ada pening pala because everyone is behaving as what they are expected to. So actually we don't need MCO, you know, That you can come up to a conclusion, either you agree, you for or against MCO, you know, it's up to you. Because you yang analyze, you yang rasa macam mana. Itu you put it into writing.
So I have a question.
Yeah.
What if after we have analyzed all three interests, the individual interest, the social interest and the public interest, and we have come to the conclusion that we conclude, let's say, obviously we would pick the public or the social interest, the bigger interest that prevails over individual interest. However, just to be critical, is it okay before we conclude that we say it is a criticism over Roscoe Pound's theory itself, even though we pick the public and social interest better than the individual interest, still he cannot make everyone happy. Or I would sound contradicting.
Tapi kita tak habis lagi dengan Tamanha. Tamanha pula, Roscoe Pound. Apa yang next after you have done the balancing? Which is not missing in this
jurul postulate.
Mana jurul postulate ni? So kalau lah kata tak ada. Okay. Sini ada jurul postulate. Tapi dia kata dalam footnote tak ada dalam content. So kalau I buat search jurul postulate tak ada. Ada tiga outcome. Mana discussion on jurul postulates? Tak ada. They end up with saying that to conclude Roscoe Pound theory of social engineering can be used to balance. You know, conclusion pun tak ada. You mesti identify which one you think is much better as compared to the other. So outcome dia macam mana, MCO ni patut diteruskan ke, tak diteruskan ke, macam mana? Because we are talking about MCO is the law. You know, that is our problem, whether we want to continue with the law or not. Nampak tak? Di sini dia, okay, dia dah cerita tapi dia tak apply. Nampak tak? May be used. What do you mean by may be used? You are telling somebody, nak makan okay, you ada sudu, ada garpu, ada pinggan. That's it lah, you buatlah apa yang patut. You know, you have to go to the extent, ambil makanan tu, letak dalam pinggan, letak garpu dengan sudu tu, bagi dekat dia makan. And that is answering the exam. It is not stating. Stating is different from applying ataupun to make real of the model or the theory into the practicality. So kita kena ada practicality. So di sini dah memang nampak lah. Tak ada dia punya juru postulate discussion. So dapat 15 lah. Takkan nak dapat 17 kot. And then the discussion dia orang, walaupun dia are focused, you know, bagi example pun ada, merata ada example-example, tapi dia tak mati kan dia punya example balik kepada problem yang dia orang nak ketengahkan. Itu dia punya lacking. Dia bagi example banyak. Tapi dia tak manage to patah balik, to relate back to the discussion. And then obviously yang paling besar ialah salah dia orang, di mana dia orang tak make a conclusion. Dia orang takut. Dia just kata may be used to balance the interest. Kita bagi problem untuk you buat decision based on your analysis. Then you balik kata, oh, saya tak tahulah, pandai-pandai you all lah. You nak buat apa? Saya dah bagi teori ni, saya dah tunjuk teori dah macam mana it is being applied. Kalau boleh nampak rationality dia, nampak lah. Kalau tak nampak, lantak kat you lah. So saya done, my job is done. Cannot. That is not the way. Okay. Soalan? Yang ni pula jurist tu kan? Ni samalah soalan ni kan. So actually for those yang jurist one ni, this is the soalan ni, tolong baca sat. Jangan risau about Tamanha dengan Roscoe Pound.
Hello sir, can you repeat back on how we're supposed to
Macam mana how to?
how should we do the conclusion?
Conclusion is up to your application or your rationality. So macam ni, eh, patah balik kat sini. To conclude, ni cuma dia bagi statement sahaja. Pandai-pandai awak lah kalau awak nak buat macam mana, you kena buat balancing. Ya, yeah, saya dah cerita dah, Roscoe Pound ni dia buat clock theory yang kata kalau you nak buat law, you kena buat balancing between interest of individual, public and society. This is not the answer. You have to, based on the discussion yang you buat kat atas, you will say that from the analysis that I have already conducted in the three paragraph above of each interest of the individual, the public and the social, then I would say it is better as compared to the individual to look more towards the public, because the public where the government is to ensure the safety of the whole society, you know, they are, it is more towards that. Yes, it is about the worry of people losing their work because the economic situation is going down because closure of all the establishment, but the more important thing is to be able to maintain social health as compared to social economic welfare. So the social health is the more important thing for us, the society, is to be concerned, especially if you look at the current trend, the number is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Nampak tak? When I say all this, you are now applying the critical analysis of all the data that you receive from paragraph untuk individual, paragraph untuk public, paragraph untuk social. So you ambil tiga-tiga tu, you dah start goreng dah. Bila you start goreng, you boleh kata it is up to you. You nak kata I think social is more important than individual. Tetapi kalau orang yang setengah tu, dia kata tak, saya setuju individual because everyone is about the happiness of individual in the society. So they have to, the law have to cater this interest of these individuals. And because each of the member of the society, they are individuals. We cannot see them as a whole society, as one. They are comprising of individuals. Therefore, individual interest is more prevalent, more important as compared to the society in general. Up to you. You can do whatever you want. There is no right and wrong answer in answering juries. Cuma, you have to be daring in order for you to start to apply. Be critical. Kalau you rasa you boleh be critical, and ini masalah ni, ini takut. Okay, you can give example, tapi you tak boleh bagi conclusion. Conclusion macam mana? There is no right and wrong answer. You don't worry about the conclusion. Then, bila you dah bagi conclusion, the next step is to talk about juris postulate pula lah. In order for you to create the law, after you have done the balancing, don't worry about the ability, whether you are going to be able to do justice to people or not, whether people are not following or not, whether people are attacking you because of the law that you create. The juris postulate comes into the decision yang you kata. Bila you kata decision, kata MCO is good, then you kena support lah jurupostulate pula punya argument to support MCO. Kalau you kata, oh no no, MCO ni mengarut, you know, then you kena kata the law have to be able to cater individual rights, individual interest in order for them to achieve the happiness that they wanted. So therefore, you would say the worry about people to retaliate in saying that people can now have cross state punya apa travel and things like that. You kena argue in saying that. So it depends you punya discussion. Can you see that?
Yes sir, faham.
Okay. Soalan lagi sebelum kita bergerak ke soalan yang sama. Tapi
sir.
Yes, good.
So that means like everyone can have their own conclusion, right?
There's yes. The even the more critical you are, the better.
Sir, you won't minus our mark, right? If we like
not in the same view as you.
No, no. I am a failure if I were to dictate my idea towards you. I fail as a lecturer if I were of jurist, if I were to say that you have to follow my idea. Tak boleh. Don't worry about that.
Then to be critical, it's okay. We don't pick one side, right? Just be neutral at the end of the conclusion where we discuss both sides of the coins.
No problem. If you decide that you don't want to come up to only one answer, you want to give all the answers that is available, then by all means do that. Maksudnya, you boleh kata ada dua jawapan dalam ni. Either you maintain or not maintain. So, maintain pun ada dia benefit. Tak maintain pun ada dia benefit. So, this is the problem, the dilemma that I have to go through in order for the government to decide which one is better. In this case, it might be undecided. However, whatever decision that is being made must have this so-called juru postulate punya implementation. Jangan takut.
So another question.
Yeah.
Just now you reaffirm many times that we should start with the problem itself before supporting it with the jurist to solve the problem. So if you also to approach it, let's say when we start the question, let's say if it's an essay question, we make a special paragraph like an introductory paragraph just to highlight what is the problem at hand, and also directly provide what juries are we going to use to solve the problem at hand in that one paragraph, and then go on to cite the juries and also integrate it with the problem.
Setengah orang, dia try to explain without the dalam soalan ni, dia memang dah bagi problem, right? There is a problem, clearly identified. There is a problem here. Betul tak? Agree, Yana?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Kalau dia dah bagi problem, kenapa dia nak kena introduce a discussion about the problem? Do you have to elaborate about this problem? Oh, saya setujulah dengan keadaan sekarang ni, memang tak gunalah, and I agree, and I know my opinion of bar counsel is also in line with that, where it is dangerous and draconian. Do you have to do that? No. Dalam court, you pun tak ada kata Tuan Hakim yang Arif. Tuan Arif tahu tak cerita dia macam mana ni macam. You nak kena baling file dekat muka you, boleh lah. This is about the problem of law, where here problem of law kan. Kalau kita problem of jurist ni, problem of from the perspective of jurist itself. Kalau jurisprudence ni is about jurist. So the same thing here, you don't talk about this in elaborating it, you know. Tapi kalau you nak discuss dalam dia punya dalam you punya answer about the facts that is given, by all means you are expected, because itu nah kita kata application. You boleh nampak beza dia. Setengah orang dia tak confident lah. Dia start nak elaborate lah, dia nak cerita lah. Macam mana-mana paper yang lain pun dia tak jawab soalan. Dia nak cerita dulu apa jadi dekat soalan dalam soalan. You are trying to elaborate. You are trying to make things simple about the question that is being asked. The facts that is given. Jangan cerita, don't try to, apa orang kata? Jangan try to elaborate the problem, you know. Don't go there. You can take the problem and discuss it. That is the one that you have to do. So kalau you tengok soalan ni, dia kata social jurisprudence, dia dah start nak explain. Okay, you don't need all this. You bagi tak ada markah. Right? Dah penat buat ni. Tak ada markah because that is nothing got to do with the problem. In his book, Pragmatism, no, what is the theory here? What is the model yang dia nak try to introduce? Again, dia nak cerita lagi. Okay. Lagi dia cerita lagi. Nah, tamah belief, tanwah belief, you know. Then theory, okay. Mana lagi yang dia nak kata ni? Pragmatism dia tak ada. Nampak dia bagi example. Okay. For example, to apply Taman-Nahar criteria, evaluative criteria, the government of Malaysia has imposed rules and standard operating procedure for MCO to curb COVID-19. They also provide penalties to those who are against the law. In addition, in conjunction with the emergency proclamation, a new ordinance in light with the spread. Okay, SCA, according to the ordinance, they elaborate lagi, right? Referring to Taman-Nahar, dia nak try to relate balik pada problem yang dia dah bagi ni. Okay, dia dah bagi problem ni, right? This problem or this example, dia nak try to relate. Referring to Taman-Nahar, this emergency right give right to impose such rule to the offenders. Okay, bila yang Taman-Nahar cakap macam tu lah? Where do you refer that Taman-Nahar cakap emergency proclamation? Dia kena bagi justification. Taman-Nahar tak pernah cakap tentang emergency proclamation. If you want to relate the problem, because dia kata emergency proclamation kan, sebab di sini dia nak relate this word and this word with using Taman-Nahar. Tapi apa pula apa ni relationship? Okay, dia kata however the first criteria might not be satisfied. Sini dia dah fail lah. Dia nak try to relate tapi dia tak boleh nak relate. Because the first criteria is to do what? Okay. You have to identify apa yang you nak kena capai. Okay. Coherent or analytical sound of the law. Di mana ada coherent and analytical punya sound of the law? Dekat dalam example ni. For example, ni apa they try to do? For example, freedom. So, you dah bagi example, you tak matikan argument of the example to back to the one that you are trying to identify. Kan, you kata evaluative criteria. Mana evaluative criteria of this? Setengah student dia bagi example that is related, memang related to the problem that is given in the question. However, example yang dia bagi tu mati macam tu je. You should be able to go back and say that this is the provision that is in line with the evaluation criteria that is mentioned by Taman-Nahar. Where you elaborate lagi elaborate sampai kupas. It is not just giving one example and not being able to relate to the problem. Relate to the problem and relate to the person that you want to talk about. Rugi, ya? It's a waste of energy. Yeah, concept must be consistent and stable with the reality which it is described. Okay, so dia nak bagi apa? This is dia nak bagi in applying to new law, ordinance is actually good initiative to prevent fake news. What is the statement of this that is consistent and suitable for the reality? Okay, dia kata sini not all people are educated and well informed. In fact, actually new to everyone, hence too much information might lead to confusion. Okay, nampak macam logik kan? What, this situation can be avoided by new law. Kenapa? This situation could be avoided by relate balik kepada consistency and suitable with the reality. Tapi dia macam tak boleh nak relate. Bila dia tak boleh nak relate, jadi ayat tu macam tergantung. This situation could be avoided with this new law. How? Dia tak justify pun. Lepas tu dia bagi on the other hand, dia dah lari daripada tadi ni. Dia dah fail untuk nak elaborate tapi dia nak pergi ke tempat lain pula. So kalau ni example lain, dia kata looking at punishment it is quite unreasonable. Apa really unreasonable dengan consistency ni? Dia panjang lah kalau kita tengok ini ya. The discussion dia sampai berapa pages? 10 pages. As compared tu yang tadi 3 pages. Yang dapat 12 markah. Bukan panjang yang akan jadi penentu untuk dia dapat markah banyak. Tapi dia punya discussion. Nampak tak? Ini dia punya very informative, very structured, yeah. Dia pergi sana pergi sini walaupun I nampak macam seolah-olah dia apa nak try, tengok ni macam ni. Apart from that assumption, lastly the assumption that people must ensure not to cross the boundary as Ryland Fletcher. You bagi Ryland Fletcher dalam nak try to justify the jurors postulate, right? Tapi tak relate. You expect the examiner understand what is the relation of Ryland and Fletcher towards the juror postulate yang you want to make a point. Tak boleh lah. You have to, jangan tinggal benda tu orang kata you pandai-pandai faham lah. You should be able to know, you are the lecturer. Tak boleh, you kalau dalam court pun you kena relate because the court knows. But how you prove is your words when you put it in down into writing and you are able to elaborate that in your argument dalam court. So the same thing here. So kalau you nak letak one example, relate the example to the problem that you want to ataupun to the point that you want to get across. Yeah, by applying, where is the application? Di mana yang dia tunjuk by applying? Dia kena explain what you mean by your application. It just cannot by the word by applying dah cukup. Okay. So dia kata ni the applying the most relevant jurors postulate to relate to the discussion is the second hypothesis or assumption. As mentioned earlier, Pound takes the consideration of welfare and society seriously, which implies Pound would like to give the best of the society. Thus, in line with juror postulate number two, where the government have to show that they are also applicable to the subject of law made and there should be no one above the law. Balik kepada problem. Di mana ada problem? Subject to the law made. Sebab soalan dia, this problem, di mana ada benda ni? So di sini dia kata conflict of interest kan? So kalau a conflict of interest, dia dah buat discussion based on the problem that is given, COVID ni. So apa orang kata, the subject matter of this is about making misinformation, right? The keyword for the whole question is about misinformation about the pandemic, right? So balik kepada yang tadi, you will say that you have to relate to the juror postulate yang you kata tadi. Okay, dah terlepas dah tangan dah. Okay, so boleh nampak tak guys? Di sini betul lah dia kata dia kena buat balancing dulu sebelum create the law, okay. Despite the need that society may vary from one phenomenon to another, it will be first priority of the government to form new rules. Any better than as compared to yang ni lah. Nampak tak? To conclude Rosenkranz theory, to ensure may be used. Yang ni at least dia kata despite the need of society may vary. Nampak tak? Ada critical analysis sikit lah kat sini ya. It will still be a first priority of government to form new rules. Nampak tak? Dia ada ayat dia sendiri. Okay? Rather than ini lantak you all lah. Lantak lah. You know? Yang ni macam I don't know what is the answer. But this one dia at least bagi the answer. As compared to hari ni kita tengok 19 ni. First, nampak? Dia tengok dalam soalan dia dah identify dah the area that is important. Tamanaha, kita tahu A tamanaha, B is dia kata B ni tak ada Roscoe Pound. Tapi the word balancing of conflict of interest, that is tamanaha. Betul tak? So you tahu first is A tamanaha, B is Roscoe. So about what? About misinformation about the pandemic, right? So bila you tengok jawapan dia. They highlight realistic social legal theory Brian Tamanaha. Okay, kita go through dulu eh. Nampak tak? Highlight dia different color. Okay. Second, highlight. Okay. Kita turun bawah lagi. Concept must have use value. Okay, then the concluding lah. Then Roscoe Pound, social engineering, conflict of interest. Walaupun conflict ni dia sepatutnya conflict of interest between public, private and social kan. So kena letak lah. So dia nak letak police reporters. Tapi dia kena highlight, dan di sini silap dia ialah dia orang tak letak. They just want to concentrate. Police is what? Public or society? Or private?
Public.
Okay. Tapi dia kena emphasize that they itu adalah if they want to do the discussion about police, then they about the interest. Now dia kata interest to interest balance. Here dia tak mention, you know, about the public. Ha, dia kata di sini, well, public interest is the police. Okay, boleh lah. Right? And then kalau kita tengok kat sini lagi, kita go through dulu eh. Second is the conflict in terms of public dengan private. Okay, so dia nak compare and contrast. Then third about the society. Okay, once they have done that, so they relate to some provision. Okay. And now they go and extend the discussion into the public institution, MKN, MOH. Nampak tak? Dia kena buat balancing lah. Yeah? So argument about what is the balancing that needs to be done. And then nampak tak? Dia kata however, you know, you are giving life to the discussion. Because tak semestinya satu approach sahaja yang kita nak kena ambil. Kita boleh ambil banyak approach. Then they come to conclusion. Right? So whatever problem this so-called between the interest of private, public and social, kena come up with the juropostulate. Then the discussion of juropostulate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5. Right, so they come to the conclusion. Kalau macam ni, right, ni pintas lalu lah, kita tak tengok detail kan. Very in-depth discussion. Memang patut lah, sebab dia tengok eh. Dia start off bukan tentang tamanaha, tetapi dia start off with the problem. Sebab dia start dengan problem. Always, dia tengok problem ni merata dekat tempat. Kalau dia tengok throughout the, dia cerita sikit lah tamanaha apa semua ni, alright. Tapi bila dia mention tamanaha punya the first identification, and then dia go to the problem. Nampak tak? Dia tak ada application in applying, tak ada. Dia jadi macam in thing. You know, something that is always maintain daripada mula sampai habis. We are talking about SOP, hari raya, security, you know. And then the second one, dia bagi example pula. Okay. Looking at the rules by the government, you know. And then dia bagi examples, the police detain and so on. Balik pada relationship to the problem. Nampak tak? According to the concept of COVID-19 rules, like must be consistent with the comfortable and situation at hand. But, jadi maksudnya, dia dah cakap tentang COVID-19 kat atas ni, right? talking about whatever pertaining to COVID-19 from the government, from the public punya point of view, then dia boleh relate, okay, and then they move on to the next criteria. Then again, they bagi example, you know, and then relate back to the argument. Therefore, in applying approach, it seems that the government must do something current. Nampak tak? Ini bukan applying in a way that cuma, ini applying sikit aja. Dia dah cakap dah tentang must something as the current values and SOP as lost use value. What do you mean by use value? Ada kat atas ni, dah discuss tadi. The use value of the situation. Okay. Questions? Banyak information yang you dapat malam ni. Mana satu yang you boleh ingat? You boleh ingat lah. First thing, highlight. Okay, kenapa you kena highlight? Because kita tak akan baca satu. Kita akan go through. Okay, so kalau ni, dia akan go through. Tengok discussion, okay, right, okay, you know, ini, then going on. So it goes like that. So kalau you tak letak key important elements atau key points, you know, the jury's name is not there, kita pula mengagau macam ni, ya, mengagau, ini ada, ini ya dalam ni, okay, nak cari siapa, kenapa, you know. Di sini ada tak tadi? Ini tak ada. Maksudnya di sini lah. Okay. Kalau lah you tak highlight, then it's quite difficult for us to identify siapa juri yang you nak bawa ke tengah. You know, things like that. Ini soalan yang ni dengan yang ni, sama soalan dia. Sebab juris tu kan. Tapi for those juris one, jangan panic. Yeah. What is his discussion is all about, and giving the general approach. General approach is the whereby you have to tengok format. It's not about the content. Okay, format dia. When nak bagi example, relate back the example to the point that you want to make across. Yeah, you want to push the point forward. So kalau you nak push the point forward, meaning you want to determine that the point is a valid point that you want to make sure that the example that you utilize can do that. Kalau you letak example, that example just berdiri macam tu, tak boleh tolong you, no point of putting in the example. Any example, be it yang macam saya cakap tu kan, social punya fenomena yang berlaku, legal fenomena dari segi akta, dari segi cases, you can bring them in, provided that you are able to relate back. Kalau you tak boleh relate back, they are standing on their own, no point. You are not going to get any points. So this group dia yang dapat 19 lah over the discussion that they have made. Throughout, kalau you tengok COVID-19 65 kali. Okay. Kalau kita tengok yang ni, COVID ada 3 kali je. This soalan yang dapat 15 ni, COVID was mentioned 3 kali saja throughout the document. Sini 7 kali. Nampak? Sini 65 kali. Meaning, nampak tak dia punya problem tu right in front of them. They are not worried about the juris. Juris will come in. Tapi soalan ni senang sikit lah. Juris dia cuma juris, dua juris. Satu Taman Aha untuk A, B untuk Roscoe Pang. Right? Tapi dia are very in-depth. Discussion is very in-depth. Kalau kita buat search macam ni pun boleh nampak 65 kali. Tengok sini. Okay? Tengok merata ada. Kalau lah kata 65 kali itu cuma dekat bahagian atas saja, tak, ni throughout the whole document. Okay, dekat sini ada. Merata ada. Okay, soalan?
Sir.
Yes, please.
Your personal preference, do you prefer us to highlight with only one color or
different
using
color
one different
for
color?
for people, different color for doc model, different color. Katalah I kata HAM principle. HAM principle satu color, meals satu color. So kalau kita buka dokumen tu, kita nampak hijau dia. Semua hijau tu represent the jurist. Kuning represent the jurist punya idea. Boleh. Nah, nampak ah, good, good. So macam ni dia try to do that. Tapi dia since you dah boleh guna color, pakai je lah color tu, bukannya susah pun. Mana konsep ni? Ni kalau dia kata Austin for Austin, mana dia punya teori dia? Tak ada color pun, tak ada italic pun, you know? Tak ada underline pun. Tadi dia boleh buat. Okay. Ha, ni civic ni dia tak ada. Mana? Tak ada. Kalau kat sini, kat sini, sini ada hard separation thesis. And then, tapi itulah very shallow. Okay, very very superficial punya ni. And salah pun. Soalan. So I will be giving you all this example for you to be able to see. You know, macam you kata, 19. Memang lah, kalau ikut Cik Nazim dengan siapa? Azlina kan? Madam Azlina. You're not going to get that. But to me, I can give you 20 if I want to. No problem. Provided that you have to justify lah. I can always justify. Come on, man. This particular group, dia dapat 19 because 65 kali dia talking about the problem throughout the document. You can see this from the analytical punya ni. You akan nampak the word COVID-19 was repeatedly 65 times throughout the document. Berbaloi dia I bagi 19 as compared to 12. Dah lah bagi 3 page. Ini berapa page? How many pages is this? Mana? 16 pages. Nampak tak? 16 pages as compared to mere 3 pages which tak ada. Nampak tak? It is not about the length but the fact that they are unable to do justice to their work. Soalan?
The method that you use just now, it shall be applicable to both problematic and essay question, right?
Yes. Tapi ingat, kalau problematic, jump to the problem. Problem is in front of you. Never take the jurist in front of you and the problem is behind the jurist. Don't do that. Problem of student ialah dia ambil jurist, dia takut. Dia takut dia nak bagi faham dulu the jurist. The jurist is right in front of you and then belakang jurist tu baru nampak problem. Jangan, don't do that approach. Bawa problem tu, ha, depan tu, depan you ada problem. So belakang problem tu ada jurist, several jurist that you might indicate in the area of answers that you want to put in. Soalan? Any questions, guys? Ada tak ada?
Tak ada soalan, sir.
Tak apa, kita boleh maintain je. Tak ada soalan, guys? I okay tau. You nak continue? Like, yeah, I'm taking your time now, obviously.
Sir, regarding the word limit and like the pages.
Don't worry. You know when you are supposed to stop. Macam ni kan? You boleh nampak tak? Dia orang punya discussion tu, it's not something yang dia orang saja-saja nak panjangkan. Anything that you put across is something that is useful. Kalau you, benda tak useful, dia akan stand out. You know, bila stand out, dia akan jadi macam, dia akan membusukkan you punya document, you punya answer. do not try to initiate the length is going to represent. Oh, lagi panjang jawapan aku ni, lagi banyak markah akan dapat. No. Kita akan go through and then kadang-kadang kita akan pangkah the whole page. Irrelevant, irrelevant, irrelevant. Eh, kalau tengok Nazim dengan Azlina punya marking, ha, eh, tengok 4-5 page. Cancel, cancel, cancel. Irrelevant, irrelevant, irrelevant. I will do the same lah. Kalau benda tu tak relevant, how can I give you point? Macam seolah-olah yang example kan, kat atas macam ni ya. Bagi try to try to make, nak bombastic lah, nak bagi bombastic kan, nak bagi siapa dia datang daripada mana, buku apa dia buat, you know, tak akan dapat markah. It is just a waste of time. It's a waste of energy, it's a waste of time, useless. It's not going to help you in getting your points. You might be thinking, wait, any effort ni, you know, I should deserve to get some kind of recognition in terms of points. Tak ada. Yeah. Dalam ni nampak to apply, dalam ni pun nampak to apply. Di sini dah kurang apply. Yeah. 12 kali. Okay, kalau sini apply 5 kali, nampak? Sini apply 12 kali. Ini apply 5 kali. Sini apply 13 kali. Boleh nampak tak? Untuk markah, yang ni untuk markah 15, right? Dia punya application, ayat application dia ni 13 kali. Compact tu yang ni dapat 17. Application apply dia 12 kali. Nampak? Tapi the length of the answer lah, dengan compare dan apply towards the final one is 19. So sini apply 1 kali. Eh, tapi entah to apply maksudnya benda lain, dia tak ada application. Aduh. Questions? Oh, ini tak ada application langsung. Eh, yang 12 markah. Yes.
Sorry teacher.
Tak apa, tanya aje.
Apa dalam soalan tu dia dah tanya tau. Contoh dia kata, do you agree with the certain theories? So dalam nak jawab tu kita kena, kita boleh letak ke I agree? Maksudnya kata nama ganti diri I tu, boleh ke atau
tidak? Yes. Yes. Because do you agree, meaning dia personalize the question to your opinion. Yes, you kena. In this case, I am undecided whether to agree to disagree, because the two argument that I put across having their own merits. So in terms of the agreement that I would say to this argument, I would argue such because you know, you give your argument because why. And on the other hand, I would disagree with this statement, because I at the same time I have some reservation with regards to the argument that was stated, and then because there is a conflict and contrast with the points that I already noted earlier. Dia jadi macam seolah-olah you dah jadi macam argue, you seolah-olah tengah argue dengan saya, you tengah argue dengan somebody. You takut nak argue dengan saya, you takut I punya standard. Jangan risau macam tu. You seolah-olah argue dengan a person that is imaginative in nature. So you boleh bagi dua-dua. Tak kisah. You boleh pro or cons or both. So you can either pro that statement or against that statement, dengan syarat you ada you punya logic lah, you punya argument lah, you punya reasons why you are saying such. Kalau you takut, then you bagi dua-dua. It's okay.
Boleh.
Lagi soalan? Good question.
So kalau kita agree or disagree, tak semestinya salah lah.
Yes. Don't worry. Because you kena argue. Because whenever you go to court, all your argument that you put across to the court, you know, to the magistrate or to the judge, it's not going to be right or wrong. Whether you are going to win or lose, that is the most important. Whether you can convince the judge. because what we are practicing right now is trying to put to put your own words across in written form. You know, argument yang you nak buat is in the form of written form, where you argue, where you analyze, where you criticize, where you agree, where you disagree. Sama dengan court pun. When you go into court, you punya mood dia tak ikut. Takkan you nak ikut tempo lawan you. You mesti kata, no, I disagree with their contention, with their analysis. Because the law, from my opinion, from my perspective, from my understanding, is going to be like this. Section yang sama boleh dapat dua interpretation yang berbeza daripada dua parti yang go to court and fight each other. It is based on the convincing factor that you are able to do towards your judge that is in front of you. That is the most important thing. So dalam kita ada 150 student yang ambil paper ni, everyone is giving their own idea based on their analysis. So as a judge, I cannot say that you are right, you are wrong. I nak tengok you berani ke tak. Kalau you kata you berani because you ada you punya foundation, you ada you punya basis, you kena you punya argument, you know, that you punya ada data, ada example, you know, which you are able to relate back to your argument. Wow, good. That is what we want you to be good at, to argue, to analyze, to rationalize, to justify. Kalau macam tu, law ni satu benda yang tak payah berubah. Law kena berubah based on your argument. Because every one of you sees things differently. Itu yang kita nak. Kita nak promote yang tu. Kita bukan nak promote parrot. Kalau promote parrot, tak guna belajar law. Belajar engineering je lah, formula. We are very subjective in nature. Boleh guys? Ada soalan? Good.
Boleh sir, thank you.
Welcome. Lagi soalan?
Sir, nak tanya.
Good.
Let's say if the question focuses solely on Islamic jurisprudence.
Good.
Should we put verses of the Quran, Hadith and also the four schools of thought in our argument as our example?
Ingat, Islamic jurisprudence yang I ajar you is coming from the basis of Al-Quran and Hadith. Nothing to be explained about mazhab, meaning things like that. Don't go to the discussion of mazhab. Okay, that is my answer number one. Jangan sekali-kali discuss about the mazhab. Mazhab, tak ada mazhab yang betul. Semua mazhab mengarutnya. Alright? Yang kita kena rely is Al-Quran and Hadis. Itu yang penting. Right? Kalau compare Al-Quran and Hadis, mana lagi important? Al-Quran. Any hadis that goes against Al-Quran, reject terus. Walaupun sanad dia valid ke apa ke, you know, sah ke tak sah ke apa ke, the criteria, those criteria of hadis tu. We are not worried about dia punya sanad tu. We are worried about the content. The content, whether it goes against the Quran or it affirm what the Quran is saying, that is a valid hadis. Okay, so okay, that is answer number one. Answer number two, kalaulah hanya hadis dan Al-Quran saja yang penting, perlukah kita letak ayat dalam Al-Quran yang you quote surah An-Nisa ayat 12, you know, things. No. This is not Islamic jurisprudence per se. Yeah, you dapat Islamic study, you know, you buat master nanti, you buat apa di LSA nanti, you akan buat benda tu. But when it comes to our discussion, is about that. Somebody, yes. Siapa angkat tangan? Anyone? Boleh nampak tadi saya punya discussion tu. So maksudnya Al-Quran tak penting, hadis mana yang tak penting. Cuma you kata on the principle of it, in Islamic jurisprudence, the most important core of the Islamic sources of law is not human law. It is about what it is being stated literally, you know, in Al-Quran and any hadith that would be able to support the interpretation of Al-Quran. Okay, so if the hadith goes against Al-Quran, totally reject. If the hadith is affirming Al-Quran, accept. However, the method that you have in the all these mazhab people, they, you know, ijma, qiyas, you know, all this interpretation are the tools, the new tools. After Rasulullah dah mati, kita dah tak ada cara lagi nak verify macam mana kita nak buat ni. Masalah baru kita dah face. Jadi macam mana solution dia? They created this so-called method of how to come to a conclusion. Istihad ke, you know, ijma' ke, qiyas ke, all those are formulas or tools that is being created after Rasulullah. Rasulullah tak pernah create benda tools tu. Okay, the tools was created in order for them to understand the sunnah, the hadith and Al-Quran. So basically, if the answer, the question is asking you, tak akan ada soalan yang Islamic per se. Yeah, Islamic soalan esok, kalau soalan tak akan keluar kata describe on Islamic 100%. One question, 20 markah. Tak akan ada. Okay, but maybe, I don't know, I haven't checked the question. So maybe kalau dia kata compare Western and in Islamic, then you Islamic part is only 1/4, okay, or 1/5. Jadi semakin kecil lah, 1/5 is semakin kecil ya, ataupun 1/10 of the discussion. Tak boleh, 1/10 tak boleh. Sebab dia kata compare and contrast between Western and Islamic. So it will be 50-50, right? Tapi the content of the Western is more, apa orang kata, more dynamic as compared to Al-Quran. Al-Quran ni dia very objective, dia very straight. So nothing much can be discussed, you know. That is my take on it. So jangan risau sangat for those yang especially non-Islam, non-Muslim. Jangan takut about the perspective of Islamic jurisprudence that you have to explain dalam your answer. Soalan?
Sir?
Mm-hmm.
Kalau in the case of macam nak side case, contoh lah kalau esok keluar like in the case of apa-apa-apa, do we have to talk about the facts also?
Or we should assume? Jangan.
I mean kalau macam contoh lah kan, contoh macam the judge in this case yang dia buat decision macam ni based because in the fact of this case is sebab dia buat ni. Ke we should assume that macam sir macam nak
you kena tanya kenapa you nak kena letak apa cakap-cakap tu, ataupun kenapa you nak kena discuss what is being said in the case by that judge. Kenapa? You kena tanya diri you. Okay, I want to cite a case. Fine, you kena tanya dulu. Kenapa aku nak kena cite this case? What is the relevant of this case to my argument yang I nak buat dalam my answer ni? And that is the first question that you have to ask. The fact that you want to put in that particular case, kenapa you nak letak? You kena tanya diri you dulu. Saya nak letak case ni, I think the reason it is important lah. Because they relevant to the argument point yang I nak bagi. Okay, fine, you can put it in. However, by putting the case, name case, the case law itself doesn't mean anything. It has to be elaborated. Now, how deep that your elaboration have to go on in order for you to do the justification, you yourself know to what extent that you have to discuss. Nak sembang pasal facts. Kenapa you nak sembang pasal facts? Is that relevant to the point that you want to make?
Sir, kalau kata kita bincang pasal adjudication process tu.
Kalau kita nak bincang adjudication process, kita nak letak
by case. Illustration.
Okay,
you nak illustrate by case.
You nak bagi case apa? you nak bincang education punya proses. The fact that the cases goes from one court to another have different outcome. So you bagi satu, you kata Teh Cempoh punya case, right? I want to highlight Teh Cempoh. It went to High Court, decision lain. It went to Court of Appeal, decision lain. It went to Federal Court, decision lain. Education. Because the subject matter of your point that you want to make it across in the exam is about education process from the judges at the level that they are in is different from one level to another. So you bagi example, Teh Cempoh in the High Court decision dia lain, in the Court of Appeal decision dia lain, in the Federal Court decision dia lain. Any case that you can bring in, provided you kena tanya, kenapa saya nak kena letak example-example ni? What is the relevant of this example in terms of akta ke, in terms of cases ke? What is the relevant to my discussion of the point that I want to make? Kalau ada, good. Jadi, bila you jawab macam tu, you sendiri akan tahu setakat mana you nak kena bincang. Adakah penting untuk bincang bincang fakta case? Kalau yang education punya situation, is it important to discuss the facts? To describe what is the fact? Education is about the decision of the judges, kan? Kenapa you nak kena bincang fakta pula? Fakta tak berubah daripada High Court, Court of Appeal, Federal Court, fakta remains the same. So kenapa you nak kena highlight fakta? You nampak ridiculous now. You are trying to impress the answer by putting up a facts of the case, by telling people that I know the facts of this case, doesn't help you at all. Ingat, boleh? You have to ask yourself, kenapa saya nak letak example ni? Kenapa saya nak letak akta ni? Kenapa saya nak letak case law ni? Kenapa saya nak letak social phenomena ni? Kalau you just nak letak, just for the sake of nak letak, nak impress, you can highlight, oh, dalam jawapan aku ni ada 10 case. Oh, my answer is going to be better than the other person. Useless. If you are unable to justify the reason why you letak that particular example. Macam pergi case, Tuan Hakim, saya bawa 100 case. So what? Judge akan kata, so what? What is the relevant of this 100 cases to the point of this particular case that we are that the case is all about? Kalau you tak boleh relate, jangan buat, itu menunjukkan memang you tak tahu. Maksudnya, sorry to say, itu menunjukkan kebodohan you. Do not put something that you cannot justify. Ni penting untuk you argue as a lawyer, as a person nanti bila kerja kat luar. You just simply want to impress people that you know the law without the ability for you to relate what the point that you are saying to the point that you are making. Habis. Jaga eh. Jangan just because you dah tahu undang-undang, you just make a blunt statement about something just to impress people. It must be something that is not pointless. It must be something that is related. Kalau tidak, jangan sebut. Boleh? Soalan lagi? Boleh nampak tak apa yang saya cakap just now ni? Ramai orang buat mistake macam ni. Trying to impress, letak macam-macam, being bombastic, you know, trying to show, cut and paste, especially dalam COVID punya sendiri, cut and paste, trying to impress. Kononnya nampak canggih lah jawapan tu. Tak ada apa-apa pun. Kita ni, kita akan nampak you lagi, ya Allah, apa ni? You tahu apa you buat ni? Nampak sangat you tak tahu apa you buat. You tengok yang 19 ni. They know what they are doing. How do you know that? But you baca, dia nampak macam flow, cantik je. You know? Dia boleh bawa example, dia boleh relate balik. You know? Nampak tak? This does not satisfy taman and evaluation of the concern. This also raises the question of, nampak tak? They relate kepada, how to say this? You can only see whenever you read a person punya answer. Okay, as compared to this, kalau you tengok main ambil 12. Apa example yang dia boleh bagi? Apa yang relationship pula? For example, government, police, YDPA. Huh? Okay. So, okay, right. If it does not come from authorized higher authority, a law can be immoral and injustice. How do you justify that? Nampak tak? It is going to be something that is ridiculous whenever you are unable to relate to the point of the question. Okay, you want to elaborate, fine lah, you want to elaborate, tapi you make it real. Kalau orang kata hard ni, kenapa? Bila dia punya teori pun tak ada, explanation to the theory pun tak ada, the application pun tak nampak, you know. So you baca pun you boleh tahu dah macam mana. If Ahmad's sister won't want to follow the rule and did not visit her sickly father and does not portray her lack of moral value to visit her sick father that needs care and attention, she is merely obeying the rule set by the government. What do you mean by that? Macam mana nak justify balik dengan Had punya idea? Pukul 11 dah. My wife dia esok you ada exam kan. Okay, so macam mana? Should we end? I takut nanti sekejap lagi you complain lah dengan Encik Arif buat soal kelas pula.
Last question, sir.
Last. Okay, good.
Last. Saya ada tengok satu soalan ni yang June 2019.
Okay.
Part B, question 1. Dia cakap, ini saya ambil.
You share, Ustaz? Ada?
Okay, saya share, Ustaz.
Saya stop.
Sharing.
Okay.
You nampak tak, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
Okay.
Yes, besarkan sikit.
Control scroll. Besar sikit. Shift ke control? Critically comment the definition and view of naturalist, the legal, positivist and historical. Alright. Apa problem dia? Kalau you tengok soalan ni, apa problem dia? Itu soalan. A dengan B adalah soalan. Dia bukan problem. Problem is the statement yang kat atas tu. So apa problem yang kat atas? In one word.
No.
Okay, kita baca sekali. Article 160 Federal Constitution provide alternative definition of concept of law. In the Malaysian constitutional system, it state that law includes written law, common law, insofar in operation in the federal in any part and any custom usage having the force of law in the federation. Yeah, okay, subject matter is the law, right? From the statement that is being made in the constitution. Now let's look at the question. Dia kata critically. Now, nampak tak? Ayat tu dia kata critically comment, meaning you are to compare and contrast. Betul tak? Sebab the word itself dah kata. On the definition of law lah tadi kan. From the point of naturalist, legal positivist dengan historical. So ada tiga group. So you can compare and contrast. So you boleh buat approach in terms of law, terus jawab. Because problem in front of you, right? The law is in front of you. From the jurist, kat belakang law tadi, our problem tadi ada naturalist, positivist dengan historical. So historical kita ada main dengan siapa? Civic ni. So kalau positivist kita ada berapa? Kita ada Hart, kita ada Austin, kita ada siapa? Austin, Hart dengan
Thurston.
Kelsen, very good. So kalau kalaulah kita nak ambil 5-3-1 ataupun 5-3-2 dalam ni, 5 maksudnya and naturalist banyak kan. Yeah. Janganlah ambil banyak sangat sebab soalan 20 markah, 20 markah kan. So you ambil 3 daripada naturalist, 3 daripada positivist, 2 daripada historical.
Okay. In this jadi, center, how much marks does one jurist usually carry?
No, it is the depth. So kalau you, kalau macam ni, you bagi satu, say for example lah, naturalist you bagi seorang, you ambil Akinas, and then you letak Austin, and then you letak historical. Obviously, you are going to get less than 5 marks. Because the question is, letak grouping rather than dia letak orang. Kalau dia kata, critically comment this definition from the point of Austin, Kelsen, and Savigny. Itu tiga orang yang you kena go deep. Then the content of each one of them mesti banyak as compared to soalan yang general macam ni. So you can go along the line of naturalist, tiga orang, positivist tiga orang, historical dua orang. Okay, so boleh nampak kan tu?
Nanti so, nampak yang B ni.
B ya, yeah? Okay, by referring to decided cases, alright, now dia suruh you ambil cases eh. Discuss to what extent each approach is adopted or rejected by our superior courts. So, you ambil case. So, subject matter untuk B bukan lagi statement atas. Okay, bukan lagi statement atas. Maksudnya depan you tu, maksudnya depan mata you adalah cases. So cases ni, the second layer adalah the law in that case and then from the perspective of this group of people.
Case apa tu?
So jadi, jurist on the second question ni memang tak, rasa tak ada, tak perlu pun. Okay, tapi takut nanti you dah lari jadi quantity punya paper pula. Ramai student bila jawab jurist ni, dia akan jadi quantity paper. Jadi apa you nak kena decide ialah you letak cases, say for example you nak letak Teh Cempo, you nak kata Teh Cempo dia punya approach by superior courts adalah berbentuk apa? Teh Cempo is berbentuk apa?
Maksudnya cases apa pun tak apa, randomly dia tak ada specific cases.
Tak apa, tak apa. Dia kata decided cases. Janganlah you create one fictitious case yang nak bawa ke tengah. Decided cases. Maksudnya decided cases, maksudnya you pada daripada asasi sampai sekarang, any cases of your opinion. Tapi dengan syarat, jangan high court, jangan magistrate court. Mestilah superior court. Superior court, high court lah kan? Okay lah. Tapi kita ambil the better one, court of appeal, federal court, you know. Maksud dia nak suruh tu is the superior court per se. Kalau you nak ambil compare daripada high court dan compare dengan court of appeal dengan federal court, baik ambil federal court as superior court, as the highest court.
So decide case tu kita ambil, kita kupas.
Kupas. Tapi kupas bukan kupas dalam constitutional law, because kebanyakan federal court cases adalah constitutional in nature kan? Don't ever do that. You kena kupas dalam bentuk naturalist, positivist dengan historical.
Oh, tapi dalam ni kita letak juris berapa orang
tu? Tu pulang, because kalau markah dia 20, I would suggest pada I, the way I look at it, 3 untuk naturalist, 3 untuk positivist, 2 untuk historical. So ada 3, 2, berapa? 8. Tapi jangan jadi macam ni pula. Yang tadi kan yang dapat 12 ada juris tapi tak ada content. So maksudnya maksudnya Ismail, jangan berpandukan kepada juris untuk menentukan sama ada saya jawab bagus ke tak. Itu cuma benda-benda perencah yang you nak masak. You know, yang penting adalah masakan, bukan perincah dia. Tapi perincah penting juga untuk masakan tu sedap kan? Yeah. Tapi kalau you perincah tu sedap, nampak power, tapi you masak hangit, tak guna juga.
So,
yes.
This is in relation to juris one, right? The approach of judges in superior court. What about juris two in our final chapter about judiciary? after we discuss about cases, let's say like judicial activism or judicial pacifism, we are allowed to cite any jurist to support that, including any jurist as long as it is relevant, right? Even though the betul. Jurist is from jurist one, just to clarify
betul.
Again.
Betul.
Okay, thank you so much.
Because topik itu sepatutnya topik yang Chacha Merba, dia campur dengan jurist one punya ni, content. Itu syllabus untuk topik tu open. Sebab subject matter dia lain. Subject matter is about the judicial punya activism tu. So kalau you nak reflect judicial activism by virtue of cases, so you kata judicial activism dari segi Donahue and Stevenson, you know, then you can see the content of the approach by the judges. So tak jurisdiction Malaysia dengan UK, anything goes.
Understood, sir. Meaning that, for example, when I talk about judicial activism in relation to employment, and then I cite Marxism, meaning that the judge has go beyond, meaning that he interpreted actively and based on Marxism punya approach.
Betul. Tapi ada case lah.
I would try to find a case just to portray the judicial activism that the judge has portrayed creatively without just following the intention of the legislature.
Ingat ni, American realism kata apa? The upper courts akan more relaxed in terms of the macam mana? The approach, eh? So the upper courts akan more towards the content of law, the discussion about law as compared to, kan?
If I'm not mistaken, it's about rules.
Rule skeptic dengan rule?
Fact skeptic. Yeah.
Good. Lewin, eh?
Lewin and Holmes is in the same boat. And then Frank, if I'm not mistaken.
Jerome Frank.
It's not predictable, but the other two, it's predictable.
Yes. So, you boleh, kalau macam tu, you nak judicial activism berlaku, banyak berlaku kat higher courts. Sorry, higher courts pula. Superior courts. Especially dekat federal court dengan court of appeal lah. So kalau you punya discussion tu more towards that. Yeah, Ismail.
That is alright. Thank you. Saya stop.
Okay. Alright. So siapa yang nak leave, you can leave. For those who yang rasa nak stay, you can stay. Kita boleh ada continuation of our discussion. I don't want you to. My wife dah bising. Dia kata kesian kat dia orang. No obligation, eh? You can leave. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you, sir.
I hope you gain something.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Thank you, sir.
Until you. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Soalan senang, jurist tu soalan senang. Don't worry.
Alhamdulillah. Thank you, sir.
Jurist one yang bahaya.
Thank you.
Good night. All the best.
Sir, can I ask one more question?
Yes, please. Siapa yang nak tanya soalan, you can sing on. I'm still okay.
Okay, just one. Just to clarify, postmodern feminism is not the same as postmodernism itself, right? With what Jürgen Habermas preaches?
Actually, dia satu group, postmodernist. Postmodernist ni dia banyak cabang lah. Kalau kita ambil feminism, dia ada postmodernism. Postmodernism of feminism. Dia sub.
Okay, faham. Oh, anyway, yeah. So can you share the example that you showed just now?
Yes. Oh. I akan bagi masuk dalam apa, dalam group, eh.
Alright, thank you so much, sir. And okay. If it's possible, the carry mark, if it's possible lah, not Nora. Not burdening you anyway, sir.
Dah siap dah. Dua. I will try to do it. Takut you future the shutdown P12, kan?
Okay, no worries.
I'll try to give you before pagi esok.
Alright, thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Take care. The rest, ada nak tanya soalan?
Saya.
Ya, Mai.
Sorry.
Tak ada. Jangan sorry. You are here, you know, spending your time. Sorry. I yang kena sorry. Kacau you.
Saya nak tanya yang satu soalan. Saya nak share sekarang.
Right. Nurul, Iza, Hafizi, Rosli, Farah, are you here, Jasmine? Jasmine tu selalu ada.
Okay, saya nampak sah.
Okay, nampak? Besar sikit. Besar kat orang lain. Global submit, okay. Apa soalan ni?
Saya nak tanya yang critical discuss the outline your draft resolution in the context mm-hmm. of foreign school of thoughts. Saya tak mm-hmm. faham. Dia kata draft resolution. Dia suruh kita apa? Resolution kah?
Tak. Dia kata draft resolution maksudnya apa yang you punya, apa you punya opinion from the perspective of historical, positivist dengan natural.
Oh,
bukannya okay. draft. I know what you're thinking of. Draft maksudnya point number one, point number two, clause one, clause two, clause three, tak ada lah tak? Jangan takut macam tu. Draft resolution adalah you nak draft resolution. Resolution ni apa? Resolution you about giving apa dalam ni freedom, right?
Yeah.
Ni human rights kan. So jadi on what basis that historical? Kata historical kata it is something that is important because we are those people who rely on our historical background in order for us to, this is proven by virtue of the theory that by civic ni, you know, you have the lupa lah civic ni dia buat apa? So you explain lah what is Vogtjies, apa relationship with regards to human rights abuses, especially that is happening, things like that. So you kena bagi example lah, lagi example apa yang you boleh nampak, and then you relate back to the historical. So boleh kata-kata nature of orang Melayu is to always obey the people who are in power. It is the nature of the Malays and the Eastern punya background. We follow the law, you know, without question. This is a nature that is negative, you know, from historical is the nature that we have to. Walaupun you represent civic ni, you don't have to actually agree with civic ni. You boleh kata, no, I disagree with civic ni. Because civic ni boleh ada dua cara. Boleh mendatangkan kebaikan, boleh mendatangkan keburukan. Okay, taat kepada raja-raja is something that is going to bring negativity in the society. So, tengok what is happening dekat Brunei, you know, taat kepada raja yang mutlak, which is like they are at that level lah, kaya tetapi miskin. Miskin minda, miskin. Ya, yeah, they can feel. You tengok lah orang yang dekat Brunei, dia biasa-biasa je. Dia tak ada orang-orang yang cerdik pandai. Cerdik pandai ni dia more towards raja-raja. So, they historical is. Boleh. You can argue anything. Waktu ni yang you nak go against something, you want to state, at least you kena ada argument. Jangan sentiment, you tak suka kesekian-sekian and then you nak cakap, tak boleh lah. Kita bukan blog. Kita kena ada basis. From the juris eh, jangan blog based on your idea. Always rely on juris, balik kepada juris.
Okay. And tu saja.
Saja eh. Okay, good. The rest? Tak ada. Kalau tak ada, we end
so, ni
lah. Yes, Efra.
Just kejap je. Let's say lah.
No, it's okay. It's not my time. Your time. I worry about your time.
Okay. Okay, kalau under juris one, law and morality kan. Betul. Let's say if ada question regarding law and morality. Betul. Kan ada debate between Devlin and also Hart.
Betul.
So, their debate based on Wolfenden report kan. Macam basically lah. Betul. So, let's say kita kena like include kan ke? What?
The debate.
The Wolfenden report tu?
And yes, also the debate you have mentioned the debate comes from the discussion report. Yes. So you kata lah to what extent Devlin punya agreement dan Hart punya disagreement. Devlin kata kena ada, kalau kata level society dah kata intolerance, indignation dengan disgust. over that subject matter, kena ada law. Lepas kalau tu, kata LGBT tak boleh di masyarakat Malaysia tak boleh terima, so kena ada law to prevent that. Tapi had kata, had dia macam males lah, had dia sokong males. Dia kata yang you nak gaduh-gaduh tu siapa, tak ada kacau you pun.
Okay, faham. Okay, that is all, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir, okay. Question. Yes, 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 please.
Sir, I just want to check whether the flow of my answer, it will be like macam, but before that, sir, kita tak payah define what is macam judicial activism tu semua, tak payah define, tak payah cerita kan?
Tak payah.
Okay, okay. Lepas tu, if like macam contoh lah dalam case ni, the judge buat something and then I talk about the case already done. So I terus, Iza terus suggest my answer.
Don't talk about the fact. The facts is not important. The judge ratio decidenda is the one that you have to, the reason for that decision.
Okay. Just talk about the gist of the case, right? So what I'm trying to say.
No, it's not about the gist. It is about the
judge, about how the judge handle the.
Jadi kita nak tahu activism dia adalah berdasarkan kepada dia punya words that he said. Iza,
okay. Alright, so, and then right, yeah, I'm here. Okay, and then right, so, lepas tu macam contoh lah kan, Iza tak setuju dengan apa yang judge tu buat dalam that decision. Do I suggest or do I my opinion lepas Iza discuss case tu atau betul, masa bawa-bawa macam dah nak dekat dengan conclusion?
Tak, dalam di mana-mana you boleh letak. Tapi jangan emphasize you punya idea is you nak tenggelamkan the judge punya decision. You can comment tapi bukan to the extent that you kata mengarut lah dia ni, I disagree 100%. you dah jadi jurist pula. You kena kata based on jurist. So from the perspective, mungkin judge tu ambil naturalist punya point of view. From that decision, you boleh nampak, oh dia ni naturalist ni. Tapi you disagree, you kata kalau ambil naturalist sahaja, bahaya sebab it will open up the floodgate kan. So you boleh kata from the positivist heart point of view, I would say heart is much better as compared to that naturalist or Augustine punya approach that was adopted by the judge. Boleh? Kalau you nak buat macam tu, boleh.
Okay, asal.
Jangan buat you jadi
jurist. Buat macam tu.
Jangan buat you jadi jurist. Okay, soalan. Siapa lagi?
Okay. Just voice out macam opinion je kan, sir. Macam contoh macam.
Opinion lah. Orang kata apa orang kata apa statement macam mana orang panggil? Sepintas lalu je. Janganlah terlampau emphasize. Kalau you nak emphasize, boleh. Dengan syarat you kena compare and contrast with other jurist. That is within the question . Kalau dia tak minta you discuss about the jurist yang you rasa lebih elok untuk dipakai pada case tu, bahaya. Tapi kalau soalan tu memang judicial activism, which in your opinion that particular case patutnya kena ada judicial activism, tak boleh jadi judge. Say for example, just nak ikut law. Kalau Stephen Poor punya case kan, kata judge federal court kata, oh since dah ada law, akta kan, kita follow akta, tak boleh lah. Dia kata, that is not fair. Then from the perspective of naturalist punya point of view, you nak ambil siapa? You nak ambil bantam ke? You nak ambil males ke? Apa semua. Kalau you nak ambil males, you boleh kata dalam Highland Towers punya yang jatuh tu, they have done something that causes people to suffer physically. I mean, how can the federal court come to a decision and say that just because there is a law to protect the government servant, okay, yeah, they can do whatever mistake that they want. Why? Because they are worried about opening the floodgate. No, you say that is wrong. In my opinion, it is wrong. Why? Because from the perspective of males, bantam, or even heart, law is law. However, the justification of the law must have to an extent that it is able to bring justice lah. Kesian dekat orang Highland Towers kan. Betul kan? Logik kan?
Bye, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Hafizi nak tanya, Margaret nak tanya. Yes. Hafizi dulu.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I am still owe you assignment 3, but I don't know how to submit the assignment.
Submit WhatsApp.
WhatsApp. Okay, sir. I will share to you, sir.
Tapi biasalah, kena potong markah lah.
Boleh, sir. Boleh, sir.
Kesian, eh. I have to be justice to bring justice to everyone juga. Okay, busy. Good.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Margaret?
So, I want to ask. Regarding the Austin and Hart debate, perlu apply both ka?
Austin and Hart debate?
Yang debate for the, apa nama dia, in the morality itu.
Ni kan Hart dengan kan perlu Austin ni. Hey, jangan buat silap macam tu. Pangkah besar ke?
Sorry, tersyasyur.
Tak apa. Syasyur sini tak apa. Jangan syasyur dalam exam.
Okay. Itulah, perlu apply both juris punya principle. Yes. Kalau kami bagi macam that debate.
Uh-huh. You bagi explanation of that debate. So that is nothing. Tak ada bawa markah. Bila you apply to the problem. Bila you apply to the problem, you boleh nampak dua-dua pihak. Dari segi Hart macam mana, dari segi Devlin macam mana, you compare and contrast. Dia kata kalau ambil Devlin, outcome jadi macam ni. Kalau ambil Hart, jadi macam ni. Saya rasa ini something, nampak you compare and contrast.
Lepas tu kami macam baru which side is better for the problem begitu. State mana satu yang lebih baik.
You boleh kata, yes, they both have merits. They do have some kind of argument which is valid in my opinion. However, in order for me to make a decision, because the question is asking me to make a decision for or against, then I will go for the against. Better because, you kena bagi because. You just jangan tutup full stop. You jangan buat full stop. You kena bagi argument. Kenapa? Mengapa you kata benda?
Oh, okay. Faham?
Always argue as a lawyer.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Alright. Okay, so siapa lagi nak tanya?
Saya. Satu lagi. Okay. Apa dalam kita punya dalam slide yang sir bagi juris one tu dalam tu semua masuk kecuali Roscoe Pound, kan?
Ya. Remove Roscoe Pound.
Okay.
Dengan Marx, kalau ada Marx ada muka dia itu juris tu.
Okay, Roscoe Pound and Marx.
Dengan siapa lagi ya? Siapa? Saya pun actually sorry lah, saya tak buang benda tu. Tapi kok mana pun juris 1 and 2 akan merge in the next few semesters. Dia akan jadi satu je.
Ianya dalam ni ada 3 slide. So sampai habislah juris 1 ke apa. Saya cakap bagi kaitan dengan juris with his syllabus, saya risau juga lah.
Kalau slide juris 1 tu semua pakai kecuali yang saya cakap tadi lah. Kalau kata Roscoe Pound, Tamanaha ke, kalau ada saya tersebut Tamanaha, so remove lah. Tamanaha akan tackle juris tu.
Good. Thank you, sir.
So the rest ada nak tanya Rosli ke? Rosli ada hutang saya. Nampak macam familiar Rosli Rahmahmat ni. It's okay. Alright, thank you so much guys. If there is no questions.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Assalamualaikum. Good night. All the best. All the best.